So this is a copy of the intraday email that I send out when there seemed to be an opportunity or something important for me, in my opinion, to communicate to you in between of the nightly videos. So first thing, obviously, this is the instrument that we're talking about. And this is the message that I want to tell you. And then the rest is always the same. This is basically doesn't change. And what else is changes is down here, which is a JPEG of the chart that I want you to look at. Everything's pretty obvious. Let me spend a little time with this middle section here, because there is some, especially here, there's some important nuggets here that I think everybody should follow. So first of all, we receive a JPEG, and usually it's some kind of consolidation, some kind of pullback area. And what we want, what this sentence is saying is that look to enter with momentum in direction of trend. That's pretty obvious. So there's a red circle on every chart I send out just to make sure people understand which way we're going, right? So there is a red circle. And then there is an arrow. That's pretty obvious as well. So this way, this is the way we're going. If this is a long trade, there's a channel. There's some kind of pullback channel, which we are working with. And this message to enter with momentum in direction of trend, which basically means don't go in too early. We need to see momentum, which means price stepping out from this channel and start to move up. In the case of a long trade, everything's vice versa for shorts, of course, for us to enter the trade. Now, normally and usually, depending on your exact settings on in your software, if you're using one of our products, you would, of course, get an entry signal from the momentum software program, which is a mathematical calculation of momentum emerging. Usually, you would get it. Due to your settings, this signal may have been suppressed, but normally, as a general guideline, there would be a signal here. Another typical situation where a signal would not appear and would not appear for a reason is simply when the pullback, when price, so price makes a move up and then pulls back, and if this pullback is not deep enough, then this signal may not trigger. And I think over thousands and thousands of trades, that's the way it should be. That's the way it helps us most. But on an individual trade basis, it can happen, and it will, it does happen, that I might point out a potential long trade, although the trade, the pullback didn't come back long enough for this signal to trigger. So that happens too. Therefore, sometimes you might see that, oh, well, we have a long trade. Okay, we're getting this email, but there's no signal. Well, there's no signal for a couple of reasons. And I just mentioned the two most frequent ones. Price trigger, that's an important concept. And we always talk about that. Price trigger means that we wait for price to move. This kind of entry technique saves us over time. We're talking thousands of trades. So it saves us a lot of trouble. We don't enter the trade unless price has already started to move. Next, consider using a stop entry. Basically, price is still down here, is in the channel, and you place a stop entry above price with either the BT or the Pro STR, which means you will handle the target and stop automatically when, if and when you get pulled into the trade. And if price never gets triggered, then no harm done. And optionally, fine-tune entry on LTF lower time frame chart. That's a very important idea for many users on premium use smaller charts, which is perfectly fine. And this sentence talks to them. Fine-tune entry on LTF chart. And by that, I mean, we discussed this in the past a few times. By that, I mean that this might be the 4-hour chart and we might be in a pullback area. So the breakout hasn't happened yet. And when, if and when we break out, we are planning to go long somewhere here. But what if you don't trade the 4-hour chart for whatever reason? There could be several reasons, of course. Well, not a problem, because then what you would do, so let's just imagine a smaller time frame, which would basically look something like this. So there would be several pullbacks within this move. So this could be a 60-minute or 30-minute chart, whatever, or a tick chart, something like that. But the idea is that you can identify this area. I'm going to use the same colors here on the small chart too. Or you can just have a 4-hour chart open. Bottom line, when we have triggered on the 4-hour chart, what you will, your job on the smaller chart, if you want to part, if you plan to participate in this trade, in this move, to find the next best entry area for yourself, which for you will be one of these pullbacks, the breakout from these smaller pullback channels. This will allow you to pick a area on a smaller chart where you can start to participate in the big move. The stop, right. A typical difficulty for traders is that I'm going to go long, I'm going to enter a trade, and I'm going to do so with a very small stop to limit my risk. Now, that idea of limiting risk with a smaller stop is just not true. It just doesn't work that way. Because what happens is that if you put your stop too close, well, I will get stopped out much more often. So at the end of the month, at the end of the year, if I all add it up, I'm at the same place or even worse. So we want to stay away from that. That's why I think if there's a Keltner, it makes sense to keep the stop away from the action and place the stop close to the Keltner channel on the other side. Beyond the most recent trading time frame pivot. Exactly. So that means that if I'm on a 4-hour chart and price has moved, then I already have a pivot here. Beyond, stop beyond most recent trading time frame pivot. So the stop should be somewhere in this area. And it should be in this area, even though I might have entered on a smaller time frame. Sometimes we call that a precision entry. Okay, what about the target? We talked a lot about the concept of 1R. So when it comes to stops and targets, I don't think it makes much sense to try to calculate stops and targets in ticks or dollar amounts, because ticks and dollar amounts are very much subject to volatility on a given instrument. So it's much better to use R as a measurement unit. Now, what is R? Just to go through this quickly, R is simply the distance between my entry and my stop. And obviously that R will depend on the time frame and on the market and on where the last pivot is and on where my Keltner might be. And that will, excuse me, that will define the 1R. Now that will define my risk. And I just use the mirror image, the same distance for my target. And the idea behind this is that markets tend to display a certain volatility characteristics. And if there is a move, usually this distance would be similar to this one, to the next one. If it is not, then that's very important information for us. It could mean that either the market is running away or the market is losing steam. So that's the idea behind the 1R. Now, partial or full profits, that's basically should be defined in your individual trading plan. Quite okay to simplify and just say that I'm going to take full profits at 1R and the trade is done and I'm on to the next trade. But of course, the price of that is that if there's any surprisingly big moves, then you will miss that. You will not be participating. If you do want to try to participate in bigger moves, then it's quite okay to another as another standard practice, which makes sense totally, is that at 1R, you remove 50% or 2/3 of your position. But as an example, let me just say you keep 1/3 of your position for a potential outlier, which means a potentially big move. And then, of course, you pull up your stop. So this trailing the stop would be relatively risk-free, apart from systemic risk or overnight gaps or something really, really like a fat tail event. And trail any remaining positions, right? So, I mean, that goes without saying. I think if I trail my runner, my third position, let's say, of course, as the runner moves away, let's say everything works beautifully, I'm not going to leave my stop down here for 3 days. I'm going to, based on some rules that I have defined in my plan, I'm going to apply the same rules each and every time, and I'm going to trail that position. You can do so excellently with our software, or you can do so manually. Our software in general was built to handle much of this automatically. Okay, so let's move on. What else is in the email? Size correctly. So overtrading means overtrading too often. And I'm putting on sizes or positions in the market, which I don't have money for. And we have calculators. I'm not going to open them up at this time, but we have calculators on our website, which you can use to calculate what is a what is the correct size. Don't make your stop other people's target. Right. So we are trend traders, but we have to remember there are, this is just a simple, very schematic situation. The real life is more complicated than that, but let's just simplify thing a little bit. So we are traders who want to trade with the trend, but there are a large number of people who specialize in exactly doing the opposite. They will trade mean reversion, which means going back to the middle. That's what they're trading. Counter trend. They're going to be putting, so what is our stop is for them, that's their target. That's their runner. That's what they're trailing and everything that goes with it. So that's why it's very important for us. Don't make your stop other people's target. Never increase stop, your stop towards risk. So if I go long, if I went long here and I put my stop here and I put my target here, this stop can only be tightened. Trade mindfully. Do not be emotionally attached to a position. Right. This is an emotional thing. We are human beings with everything that goes with it. This is a probabilistic job. So nobody knows the future. We are working with probabilities. If I enter long here, the trade can go this way or price and price can go this way. But sometimes it goes against us and sometimes the trade will not work. I hope you will agree, or I think you will agree. I think it's a pretty elementary mistake, but a stage that most of us do go through initially is that we start to judge ourselves by our trades, our self-worth or our emotional state. So whether the last trade was a loser or a winner, it doesn't really matter. It shouldn't really matter on a personal level. I'm still the guy I was 10 minutes ago. I'm not stupider. And also, if this worked beautifully and I just made a truckload of money, it doesn't mean that suddenly I'm a genius if I wasn't a genius 10 minutes ago, because these are just probabilities and both will happen. So we are not our trades. This is the website address, the premium page, and a couple of legal things, and that's it. And also, I want to mention that this is an intraday email. We have a separate unsubscribe link here, which only unsubscribes you from the intraday trade intraday emails, but you would still have, of course, have access to the premium page itself and the videos and everything. And of course, here's an option to unsubscribe, but only from the intraday emails. If you want to unsubscribe from the whole premium service, then you can do that on this page. So that's from the full service. This is only from the email, from the intraday emails. So that's what I wanted to say about this. Thank you very much and good luck to you, and we'll talk soon.